So, yang and yin go together. But through not seeing this, the whole of our life is, as I said, geared to the thought that we might be able to make the yang side win. And so, in every sort of human enterprise, we are trying to have white without black. When you talk about improving the world, you are meaning presumably that you want it more white than black, or whichever one you call the good one. Maybe you think the black is the good. It's all right, it makes the slightest difference. You know, which side are you going to take in the game of chess, the black or the white? Doesn't make much difference, except white gets first move. No, I'll always wait to see what you're going to do. We think, could we get rid of the other one? Now, as you know, in all matters of practical living, it never works. You think now, I've been miserable all this time because I haven't had enough money. I never know whether I can make the payments on the car. I never know whether, there's going to be sickness. And if only I had a little more money, I'd really feel great. So you get it. And in the transition from one stage to the other, whoops, you feel very elated. Of course, you feel elated. You're going up $5,000 a year, say. That makes a difference. When you've gone up, then of course you're on a level again. And no longer do you have to worry about making the payments. But you get a new worry. Supposing I get sick and die of it. Supposing someone robs me, takes it away from me, and worry about that. You say, oh, I'd feel so much happier if I had a medical examination. As you go to a fancy doctor, he says, I can't find anything wrong with you. But then always there might be burglars, so you get an alarm system and new locks. And finally you go to the Homes Patrol and get a private guard to watch you, and that makes you feel better for a while, except then it begins to nag you. Gee, if I have that Homes Patrol man out there, they'll know I've got something. Maybe I better have two men on the job. So, it grows. You worry. Because you found out that you didn't get yang without yin. You got a new yang, a bigger yang, instead of the former little one you had, but you got a big yin with it. It's no joke getting rich. It implies a great deal of responsibility, and you've got more to worry about. Don't envy rich people. It's a great mistake. Don't envy anyone. So, in the same way, Zhuangzi puts it thus, he's Lao Tzu's successor. People who speak of having good government without its correlative misrule, or right without its correlative wrong, do not understand the basic principles of the universe. One might just as well speak of having yang without yin, and such people must be either knaves or fools. Of course, how would we know we were wise unless there were knaves and fools? But here it is, you see. You cannot beat the game. You can have the temporary illusion of winning, but by compensation, you will ever so often have the temporary illusion of losing. When you go down a step, from yang to yin, you'll feel, I've lost something. When you go up a step from yin to yang, you'll feel I've gained something. How would you know gain without loss? How could you have the sensation of more unless in relation to the sensation less? For sensation is simply awareness of contrast. That's what life is. Now, if we realize that, we get the same feeling of frustration as I wanted to give you this afternoon in trying to make it clear that so far as the improvement of ourselves and of the world is concerned, there's absolutely nothing we can do about it. And this is simply another way of saying the same thing. You cannot have more yang than yin. You cannot play a game which is win and no lose, or a game in which everyone wins. You're stuck with it. Now, in just the same way, if we recognize that, applying yang and yin to all the possible situations of life, we get this awful feeling of, so what's the use? I mean, what do you expect me to do? Jump into the river and drown? Now, wait a minute. Why, at that point, do we get the feeling of, oh, what's the use? Simply because we've found that our favorite game won't work. And we think that is the only thing for which there is any use, is the game in which white must win. But why not change them around? Isn't that a good game? Because they go whiny, 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 like this. Goes in and out. It's the undulation of a wave, the crest and the trough. You can go on a, you know, every kid likes a roller coaster ride. You go, it's great. So having both is the game. See, it's no game. What we think is the game isn't a game at all. To win all the time. Win, win, win. That's no game. Because the game is always the hide and seek. Now you see it, now you don't. The game is the story in which the villain might win. And the whole idea of drama is to make it seem to the audience that it is the villain absolutely must win. There's no way out, and then suddenly, for whom, a secret thing is revealed and the hero wins. Or if you want a good cry, they have a tragedy and the villain wins. But don't you see? There is no vitality unless there's that negative element. The villain, the devil, the nothing, the death, the out. You've lost. Finish. Bye-bye. Quits. See, if that's not there, then the other one isn't there. And you're always winning. Supposing you know, you sit at home with your wife and you play cribbage. Lots of married couples try to forget holy deadlock by playing games at night. And if one partner, be it wife or husband, always wins at cribbage, the game ceases to be of interest. Because every good player likes a sprightly opponent who sometimes wins. Wins just a little bit less than me, mind you, but he wins a great deal of the time. Yes, it's okay. Just a little bit. No. So, if you don't have the unknown space, death, darkness, negative, you don't have the light. So the art of life consists rather in something else than trying to make white win. You needn't sit down and weep because somebody tells you you can't make white win all the time, forever and always, so that black doesn't exist. Because black, by its very nature, is darkness and it doesn't exist. You're trying to make it not exist. It's irrelevant. The very fact that it doesn't exist is its power. Non-existence is the necessary condition for existence, just as like you have to have a front before you can have a back, or back before you can have a front. They come into being together, so do existence and non-existence. So what are you afraid of in trying to get rid of nothing which is already gotten rid of?